For more Bollywood gossip, hit the bell icon and never miss a video. Ulia wants to make her relationship official. Sources reveal that Ulia has requested Salman to officially add her name with Salman Khan. No, the diva does not want to get married to him, but instead she wishes to produce films with him. Yes, Ulia expressed a desire to produce a film and hopes that all the films produced under Salman Khan Films banner should have Ulia's name along with Salman as the producer. Although Bhai is yet to give the green signal, we are not really convinced that Ulia's wish will be fulfilled. What do you think? Do let us know. Ever since Malaika Arora and her ex-hubby Arbaaz Khan parted ways, there were rumors of the diva dating Arjun Kapoor. The two have never made their relation public, but have often been spotted together at various social tours. Despite being warned by Salman Khan, Malaika and Arjun continued to meet. But now the two have decided not to give room for any more gossip. Sources reveal that recently Malaika and Arjun both were invited for a party and the two of them had plans to attend the duo. But at the 11th hour, the two changed their minds. This is because the two didn't want to be spotted together. In an earlier party too, the two had planned their exit separately to avoid chatterbugs from clicking them together. But still, they could not curb the rumors. And so the two have decided to avoid all Bollywood parties till the hue and cry dies down. So what do you think of their decision? Do let us know by commenting in the section below. Amitabh Bachchan turned a year older and on his 75th birthday, his family had planned a special birthday bash for him in Maldives. Just yesterday, the Bachchan clan had headed to Maldives where there was a special celebration planned by Aishwarya, Abhishek and Shweta. The family celebrated on a private beach with crackers and a huge cake. They plan to spend some really great family time and pamper Big B to the core. Here we have an amazing picture of the family languishing on the beach and my, we simply can't marvel at the class they exude. While we await for more pictures from this family celebration, don't forget to share your comments with us in the section below. The 11th season of Big Boss is creating ripples since the first day itself and host Salman had to even oust a contestant due to violent behavior. Another contestant Zubair Khan, who has since then been out, had earned a lot of flack for abusing women on the show. And now Zubair Khan's woes have not ended. It seems that Zubair Khan had been lying about being related to Daud's family. Zubair had claimed that he was Daud's sister Haseena Parker's son-in-law. That's not all, he even claimed that he was the co-producer of the film Haseena Parker. Hearing all this, the real co-producer of the film Sameer Anthule got really livid. Being the actual relative of Daud, he issued a statement saying that Zubair's claim is creating issues for Haseena's daughters and Zubair will have to pay a price for this. That's not all, he even revealed that in 2014, Zubair had met Haseena with a request to make her biography, which he immediately refused. Now if this news is true, then Zubair is in a big trouble. Don't you think so? Do let us know by commenting in the section below. Khiladi Akshay Kumar is one hell of a versatile actor whose choice of films is always a surprise package. What with his playing God in Oh My God, a lawyer in Jolly LLB 2, a simple villager on a mission for Toilet Ek Prem Katha, now Aki is out to play a super villain for Rajnikant's robot sequel titled 2.0. My, it's like never before. Akshay Kumar's character looks so amazing that we simply can't help but marvel at the genius that he is. Aki's character has numerous shades and is quite attractive. Here we see how he emerges in a whirlpool of sand with bats hovering in the background. At the first glance, it is enough to send a chill down your spine, but later we do marvel at this amazing masterpiece. So what do you think of Aki's character? Do let us know by commenting in the section below. Zubair Khan, the contestant who was ousted in the first week itself, has filed an FIR against Salman Khan, stating that the host of the controversial reality show Big Boss had threatened him. Zubair also stated that Salman Khan was involved in underworld and drugs. Zubair, who has been speaking to various channels, stated that he was ready to return to the show only if Salman Khan pleaded with him and apologized. However, insiders working with the Big Boss team revealed that it was Zubair Khan who had actually spoken rudely to Salman Khan and not the other way around. Well, after Swami Om in the previous season, this season Zubair has tried to irk Salman, and we wonder where this will end. What do you think? Do let us know by commenting in the section below. Dabang Khan Salman has worked in a wide array of films and all his roles have been loved by his fans. Be it the quintessential Prem to the daredevil spy tiger. But now the Bhai will be seen in a negative character for the first time. Yes, we have reported how Salman would be playing a gray-shaded character for Race 3, and now we got to know that before signing the film, Salman had laid down three big conditions for the makers of the film. First, the film should have more humor and punchlines. Bhaijaan loves to do films that are funny, and so he has asked the makers to up the humor quotient. 2. The film should not have any steamy scenes, as he wants to live up to the standards of a family-friendly film. And last of all, he does not want his character to be involved in drugs. Salman has a huge fan base of all ages. Having a drug peddling scene may have a negative influence on his fans. This is a strict no-no for him. So what do you think of these three conditions? Do let us know by commenting in the section below. After delivering hits like Gupta, Hidden Truth, Soldier and other films, Bobby Deol's career experienced a lull and began to fade. He hit an all-time high with Yamla Pagla Diwana in 2011, after which the ebbing continued once more. Recently, he made a comeback with Poster Boys and now he has already signed a new project, and that too with Salman Khan. Yes, we are talking about Race 3. Bobby Deol is the latest entrant into the Race franchise. Producer Ramesh Torani, who has earlier worked with Bobby in Soldier and Nawab, has confirmed this and stated that he will be seen in a never-before avatar. Now this is one hell of an interesting news. Don't you think so? Do let us know by commenting in the section below. Mika Singh is a powerhouse of energy and he has delivered umpteen hits of numbers in films. No wonder his latest offering, Sexy Palliye, from the film Secret Superstar, was a delight to the ears. Amit Trivedi has kept the fun element alive in this peppy, foot-tapping number, which makes you jump out of your seat and break into a jig. Amir Khan looks a perfect tapori with his red banyan and jeans-clad look with the word Sexy Palliye printed on it. All in all, this is one hit number who will rule the charts for a very long time. Don't you think so? Do let us know by commenting in the section below. The much-hyped trailer of Padmavati is out and has taken the web by storm. The grandeur and opulence, coupled with three amazingly talented artists and a director who knows his job well, is clearly a jackpot formula for the box office. In fact, industry insiders are already looking at Padmavati to redeem the lackluster response of films this year. On this note, we hear that Salman Khan is now worried after seeing the trailer of Padmavati. After seeing the lukewarm response to his Eid release Tube Light, Salman Khan is now eager to make his film Tiger Zinda Hai work. But now it seems that as Padmavati is releasing in the same month, Salman's spy thriller will have to face tough competition and he stands a good chance of losing the race. Well, as both the genres are not the same, we guess there is room for both the films to prove their mettle. Don't you think so? to let us know by commenting in the section below.
मुझे बोलना है थोड़ा सलमान खान को कि जो लेडीज को लाए लेडीज आरती वो तो इतनी गंदी लेडीज है, कपड़े आधे आधे पहन के पूरा दिन ऐसा ही लड़के लोग ये करेंगे तो लड़के बोलेंगे नहीं, गुस्सा नहीं आएगा लड़के लोग। मुझे सलमान खान को यही बोलना कि आप ऐसी ऐसी लेडीज बनाते हो और खाने में थूकती, बोलते खाना में थूकी उसने, तो क्या करेगा वो, क्या करेगा वो। तुम ऐसी ऐसी गंदी गंदी लेडीज लोग बुलाते हो और लड़की कपड़ा पहनने का जिसको मालूम नहीं है, हाँ कपड़ा पहनने का ढंग नहीं है। हम तुम लेडीज है, मैं प्रेसिडेंट हूँ और मुझे मालूम है लेडीज का क्या है।
आप बोलो
पैसा
ये बोलना है तेरे को, किधर कुत्ता बनाने का है। मैं चैलेंज देता हूँ, चल वहाँ आता बगैर बॉडीगार्ड के आना।
नहीं नहीं, बॉडीगार्ड लेके भी आए चलेगा, मैं बैंड्रा में रहती हूँ, बैंड्रा में रहते हो, कुत्ता बना के बैंड्रा लेकर आ रही हूँ, बोलो किधर आना है।
थैंक यू।
कुत्ता बना के
अब यहाँ से कहाँ जा रहे
हो? मैं
अरे इधर एंसिल लिया क्या, नहीं लिया क्या, ऐसा कुछ सवाल नहीं किया क्या?
हाँ बोलिए, जाना जरूरी
इधर का एंसिल से
व्हाट्सएप पर करूँ ये
चलो ओके
दो मिनट
अरे हिला मत यार।
हाँ मम्मी गाड़ी ला,
क्या बोलिए।